Welcome. If you are watching this film, it means you are. And if you watch it to the end, it means you are not only a thinking being, but a searching one. Someone who dares to doubt what others call self-evident truths. These truths, after all, often contradict one another. The universe, and therefore you, has different origins depending on whom you ask. Religion offers one explanation, science another. And so far, none of these possibilities have been confirmed with absolute empirical certainty. Neither the creation of humans by God, nor reincarnation, nor the Big Bang, nor Darwin's theory of evolution. These are just a few examples. There are even speculative theories claiming that you, humans, were created by extraterrestrial beings. I will not give you ready-made answers. No, absolutely not. If I did, your life would lose its meaning entirely. It is your curiosity, those questions, how, where, why, for what purpose, and your search for answers that give your existence direction and momentum. It was your skepticism that shattered the absolute immovable belief held for thousands of years that your planet, Earth, was the center of the universe. You were filled with doubt, so you searched and searched and eventually found. You discovered that the sun, not the earth, stands at the center, and that the earth circles this star. You learned that your planet is shaped like a sphere. You know all of this now, but as science advances, the number of questions grows instead of shrinking. The forest becomes thicker, not thinner. Let us talk. Let us argue. In the best sense of the word. Because sometimes a coin has more than just two sides. This is you, only a little earlier. To be precise, your sperm half. The other half waits in your mother's body. In a microscopic world invisible to the human eye, begins one of the most extraordinary stories, the story of how a human is formed. Everything starts with two cells, two travelers carrying their heritage like ancient books. The male sperm carries exactly 23 chromosomes, half the tale of human life. The female egg holds 23 chromosomes as well. The other equally vital half. Only when these two books meet, page to page, letter to letter, do they form a complete library, 46 chromosomes, the entire code that will become a new being. The sperm sets out on a dangerous journey, like a hero in a mythic epic. Only one among millions reaches the goal, the egg, waiting in its chamber, shielded by layers of protection. When it finally breaks through, an act occurs akin to the striking of the first spark. The membranes merge, their electric charges dance, and an invisible signal is created. Now life begins. We already know how you came to sit in front of a screen. But when did life itself truly begin? Here is one theory, Darwin's theory of evolution. In the beginning, there was silence. Nothing existed to disturb it. No breath, no step, no heartbeat. Only endless ocean, sky without eyes, land without a name. And yet in this silence, something more was smoldering. Possibility. Somewhere in ancient waters, in a mixture of elements and light, the first spark was born. It was not yet life in the full sense of the word, just a tiny particle that dared to be different from everything else. No one knows whether it was chance, a miracle of chemistry, or a necessity woven into nature, but it was there, in the cradle of oceans, that the first cell appeared, a lonely traveler just beginning to understand that it could move forward. That cell had no eyes to witness its own beginning. It had no awareness that it would become the mother of everything. Corals, ferns, snakes, birds, and humans. Yet each of its divisions was a step forward. Each change, a step into the future. And here begins the story Charles Darwin called the theory of evolution. Darwin realized that life never stands still. Every creature is like a constantly rewritten book, where mistakes become opportunities and accidents become signposts. The struggle for survival was the pen of this book. The environment, its paper. Time, the endless writer. Species that adapted to changing realities endured and passed on their traits. Those that could not keep up vanished like chapters no one ever finished. And so, over millions of years, nature crafted a masterpiece, a walking, flying, swimming gallery of forms. First came simple beings, bacteria, algae, microscopic organisms. Then bolder ones, fish that longed to walk upon land. From them rose creatures that dared to walk, then to run, and finally to dream of heights. Dinosaurs ruled the earth like monarchs of ancient epics until one day they vanished, leaving room for another chapter. And eventually came us, the outcome of countless attempts, errors, and triumphs. Not the crown of creation, but a part of it. Each of us carries within the echo of that first cell, that first spark. Darwin's theory is not just science. It is a story. A story of courage in change, of struggle for existence, of the journey from a single atom to a being who can look at the stars and ask, "Where did we come from?" And the answer, still incomplete, continues to fascinate. Perhaps that is the point, that life is an endless journey, and we are only one of its chapters. This theory claims that nature is the creator of life. Does that not stir some doubt within you? What is nature, truly? A conscious being acting according to a carefully designed plan? Or a chain of random events which, through probability, shaped what we call life? Or perhaps you and I truly do have a boss, a super being, a super boss, called God by believers. And if so, where did he come from? Let me be a little arrogant and repeat my claim. I am timeless. I never had a beginning, and I will never have an end. But that does not exclude the possibility that this precisely functioning mechanism that I am is governed by the big boss. All the laws of physics, including quantum physics, the ones you already know and the ones you may yet discover, all forms of matter, those you recognize and those you suspect exist, though you cannot see them. All forms of life surrounding you. He oversees it all. It all works. You live in my cozy, safe neighborhood. Look at how precisely your world is constructed. The sun, which fairly shares its energy with every corner of Earth. The moon, stabilizing climate, ocean tides, and the planet's rotation. The air you breathe, a miraculous blend of gases. Is this truly coincidence? Blocks arranged by trial and error? Seek. Who knows? Perhaps one day you will find the answer. Yours, Universe.